Okay guys, this is version 1.1 video, basically showing the cooler that I built. As you remember from earlier in the post, you can tell that I've done some modifications compared to version 1.0, because 1.0 only had two marine grade 5-inch speakers, this watertight box installed into the top, sunk in through the lid, and had the amplifier that is sitting right over there. The amplifier went out on me, so I can't use that anymore. So I decided to upgrade from an earlier picture, you could tell, the pile head unit and four speakers. And I also got an antenna just for the heck of it. Of course, the pile came with the faceplate cover. Flip that up, and there's the head unit. You can see there my aux input, drilled a hole through to bring the wire inside due to the fact that my iPod is sitting in this blue box. These speakers are marine grade pile 6.5s, and you can see here that I have the idea from Motorboat with the vent hole covers. I have one on each side, the second one being over here. One's an intake, one is an out. Then we open it up, and you have the inside of it. You have the 5-inch speakers, you have four speakers on each side. I have a regular Everstart lawn and garden battery. I have the 120 millimeter computer fan. Decided to go with a little bigger just because I wanted to push as much heat out as possible. You can also see that here on the box I have this cord sitting here kind of zip tied. It's the 3.5 millimeter male end and the male end of the RCA cables. That's what was plugged in for version 1. To the amplifier, but since that burned out, I had to go a different route. Due to the fact I also couldn't find the cord for the male end and female of the RCA jacks, and a male end of the 3.5. So I also turned my top two speakers into tweeters by getting some bass blockers from a local audio store. I got them each on there. It says to hook them up to the positive side, but I found out that these speakers, for some reason, they sound better hooked up to the negative side. I'll have the other video, attached at the end of this, of the sound of it playing in the living room. But as for how this works, I have it watertight box. This is where I keep the cigarettes, phone, everything. I have this rag in here due to the vibration, so that the iPod and everything in there doesn't sound horrible. Here's my on-off switch, right here. I painted the inside of this watertight box because in version 1, this was actually a clear like this. You could see straight through it, and the iPod was getting extremely hot. So I just got some local plastic white paint to help reflect it, and it worked on the river very well. But as you can see, you flip the switch, and what that does is I have it all hooked up to turn on the fan. You can hear the fan blowing that air out, and then that also turns on the head unit. You can see the little blue light right there, and I've got a remote, waterproof, to turn on the head unit. And so this is just a little sound demonstration. We basically turn it up and down, all that good stuff. So that's it for version 1.1. If anybody has any questions, don't be afraid to ask. I will be getting some advice for a version 2.0. I'll be asking some certain people on the forum. So please do respond to that. I have some ideas. I just would really like some advice. Thanks, guys, and hope to hear from you.
Inception, you got a mother dreaming. Mr. Worldwide.